up, YouTube?
What's up?
This is your girl coming at you with a car review. Today we are reviewing the 2020 Kia Telluride. Isn't she so pretty? Look at that grill on that thing.
Looks like a Range Rover grill to me.
Yeah, but it's a Kia. And then it does a system check.
Full system check.
Every time you start up the vehicle, you have these functions on the side right here. These are the road assist. You have road assist. It actually show up on the side view cameras. I mean, on the windows, right? It's push to start. So you got push start here. You got all your little function, the rear, the AC, the rear climate controls. All your climate controls are there. Then you have the
basically the brain.
Basically, but something I like that I've played with on this car is your menus, and you can go ahead and you can control basically everything that goes on in the car by this. And of course CarPlay and all that kind of stuff, but that, you know, that's standard in these vehicles these days. But what I do like is that you can control the music, the back music from the front. So if you have children and they're napping in the back, you can cut off the sound, the music to the back two rows, so they can sleep in peace, but you can still listen to your music up here. So I like that. I like that you can also turn off the climate controls back there. So if it's too cold for the kids or whatever back there and they sleep, you can do all that from the screen here. And then they also have their own climate controls back there too.
You turn it off, turn it on. Turn the heat, set it to heat, or set it to cool.
Then they have their climate, their air conditioner vents on both sides. Then up here on the top, you have your lights. You have
shades.
Yeah, for your shades. You have your UVO here. And the UVO is basically the whole brains of the car. That's what they call it, UVO.
UVO also has an app that you can download.
Oh, yeah, we forgot about
control
that.
Control your car, turn it on, turn the air conditioner on if you out shopping like she does. Out shopping and want to turn her air conditioner on when she's done and she's in line using them coupons. She can just go to the UVO app
and turn the vehicle on before I get to the car. So, right. So by the time you get to the car, your car is already cool off. So you're not hot. You know it's hot in Georgia right now. What else is good on here? I mean, it just have a lot of functions, a lot of things that we didn't even check out yet, but.
But like we said, we just got it.
Yeah, so we just got it.
We haven't had time to get deep indulge in it.
And then also you have your volume up and down here. You can also change your music here. I don't know what these are for yet.
That's cruise control.
I'm a woman, so I get in the car and the drive. I actually should let my husband do this because he gets in the car and push buttons. I don't know what half of these buttons are for.
I know what most of them are, some of them.
All right, well, tell them what these buttons are for.
These are your drive modes. Now, this is what really got my attention about the car, is the drive mode. As you see at the dashboard, you can go from sport to comfort to eco to smart. And basically, my wife don't want me to drive in sport because sport and all four tires are pulling. So sport is when you finna do some riding. Comfort, I think I drove in comfort like twice when we first got it. I really couldn't tell what it was doing. But eco is like it's basically all four tires are pulling, but not at max capacity. And smart is, depending on what you're doing, that determines what tires are pulling. So if you're going uphill, you'll have the back tires pulling. You're going downhill, you have the front tires pulling, stuff like that. But that's a real neat feature that I saw. And also right here, you have the electronic parking brake. You have the auto hold. The auto hold is a neat feature. Like when you
like that one.
Yeah, she like that. When you're in the drive-through, and you order, especially if you go to like Captain D's, where it seems like it take you 10 hours to get your fish.
No, it only take you 10 hours in Captain D's to get your fish.
Whoever it take the long. But When you hit the auto hold,
whoever
take the longest, don't do me. Whoever take the longest in their drive through, you push this auto hold, and you could just take your feet off the brake to give your foot a rest, and the car will sit still, electronically braking.
I do like that feature. Yeah. I've used that one a couple times. I don't use a lot of features. I'm the type of girl, probably just like woman, just like all other women. As long as they have gas in here and the AC, I'm good. So
right.
I get mad when I get in the car and I have brakes and lights and stuff flashing because he didn't push the 100. Like, I mean, push the 100 buttons. But that's just me. I just, you know, I don't know. Anyway.
And right here, you have.
It's a little dusty, you guys, because we was going to go get a wash tomorrow. It's been in the garage.
But right here, you have the USB ports. You have two right here. And for some reason, they have a lighter port in here. I ain't seen a person
that's
with a lighter in
their car.
What is it?
That's a 12-volt point.
Oh, that's for the car charger.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm learning something y'all learning.
Mm-hmm.
Then they got...
And the only thing, you guys, that I had to get used to was this big behind gas pedal. This thing is so long. Like, I wear a size...
It's power pedal.
No. Ladies, I wear a size 10 shoe, and this thing is long, bigger than my whole foot. I had to get used to that.
Right.
I never saw a gas pedal that was so damn long.
It did it on the big
no,
old
this
Camino.
Thing is long as hell. Anyway, now one thing I did find crazy, well, two things I found crazy or I don't like about this car is the glove compartment is small. Mm-hmm. You see this book? This is the book that comes with it, right? And then when you try to close it, when you put it in there and try to close it, you had the borderline just, see?
Slam it closed.
Stuff it, because it's, and nothing else can go in there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, got all that other stuff.
Now, the car does not feel cheaply made. It feels real good, but that was one of the things that I did not like about the car. And also, this thing over here. This is like a thing to mount your foot on or whatever. When you push on it, you hear it. You feel it going down like they could have put some...
They got a bubble in or something?
No, it's like cheap-ass plastic.
Mm.
See? Because, mm-hmm. like if you're trying to move, especially if you're a big girl, trying to put your weight down on it, that feel. And this piece of plastic right there, see that? I don't like that, but I bought it now, so... It's not too much I could do with it there.
Yeah.
Okay, now the window's pretty big. Oh, damn, Lord. Mirror. I see myself in there. I might have to edit that part out.
Yeah,
the windows are pretty big. And at night, you know, you have a little light up there in both sides.
Mm-hmm. The vanity mirror.
Yeah, the vanity mirror.
Opens. Close it back.
And another feature I found. Because I'm still learning, so I learned so many things about this car. But what I do love is if a vehicle is coming or approaching and my passengers are trying to get out the car, it will have signals on the lights flashing and blinking so they know that is a vehicle.
It's a car approaching.
Yeah, it's a car approaching, it's oncoming traffic or whatever. So that's awesome, especially if you have kids. You know, sometimes kids try to jump out the car. And I think this back door lock. If it's a car approaching, the back doors will lock so the kids can't just jump out the car.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a safety feature that I really, really, really love. But anyway, let's go into the back of the car. And of course, you got your console. It's a pretty large console.
Yep.
Get out my console. You don't know what's in there. What?
Okay.
And then you got two cup holders there. And you have the three seats in the back. We didn't get the captain seats.
What? Because
these seats back here are pretty spacious. Oh my goodness. I sit back here and I never like to sit in the back. Right?
Right.
So these are pretty comfortable, but it also have cup holders there.
Then the door. You know, standard. The child lock left and right for your windows.
The mirrors, yeah.
Yeah, the mirrors. And also you have buttons up here for your garage door opener.
Mm-hmm.
But we haven't set that yet. We still use The old trusty.
Mm-hmm. Oh, reliable. Trusty.
Okay, so now we're going to go see what the back did. Pretty room. See, I can sit here. See my little feet or big feet. And you still have a lot of room.
Ample leg room.
Well, babe, we should have left the car on. Because it's hot.
Open the door.
No. I want to talk. And then again, we got two cup holders back here. Another thing I do like is the charger ports here. Because, of course, if you have children, you know, they have iPads and iPhones and doodads and whatever whenever we're going out. And another thing I like is these little hooks on both sides. Book bags, pocketbooks, or whatever like that. But like I said, it's pretty spacious back here. It's over there and more charger ports. Like, you get a lot of charger ports, which is probably needed in these days. Another charger port. Two more cup holders over there and little cubby holes right here. And actually, it came with a cover back here, but we don't use it. But this is what these two holes are for, a cover for the back. Yeah. And this is the third row going up.
You have to pull these seat belts to make it snap in.
Mm-hmm.
If you just pull them back, they won't snap. So these seat belts be blocking.
Yeah. But anywho, now this is pretty spacious back here. I don't know if you guys can see, I'm in an awkward position. But the grandkids love it back here. Well, the children, point blank, they just love it back here. More air vents back here.
Voila, magic. It goes all the way down. Then I push the right one. Voila, magic. And this right here, that's what I was saying, it has another port.
12 volt.
Yeah, 12 volt port for another charger or whatever. And then right here is a, basically a cubby hole. Where if you have additional stuff that you want to, and down there up under that is the spare tire and a jack and all that stuff. But that's a lot of room for, and this just comes off and slides back into place, snaps in. And yeah, those seats go all the way down. Basically, that's it. It has the lift gate with the button. Push the button and it pops up. You see the rear view mirror, everything like that. Then you have the Telluride with the inverted L lights. For y'all that don't know what inverted mean, that means upside down. I learned that when I was watching the video about it. Charcoalish, hot coalish gray something color, but we like it. And you see these four windows right here came all tinted. These two, you had to get tinted. So we just got those tinted today. I had my little partner Juan come out here. You had to say a name like that. Juan came out here and did my tent. But we like it. That's the light for the signal light on the side. I like the style it's made. I like the LED lights. I like all that. And like you said, it's got the Range Rover-ish grill on it. It fits in my garage almost perfectly. Don't leave too much room for wiggle. But like I said, we like it. She likes it. That's all that matters to me. 2020 Telluride.
That's right.
And over here we got the 2016 Malibu.
Malibu,
see? Hey, see my partner Juan did these wonders too. Don't look legal, but we're going to ride till it is.
Don't call me if you get a ticket.
I ain't get no ticket. Don't worry about that.
Don't call me.
That's it.
You better call
them. So if you guys are thinking about going out, you need an SUV at a reasonable price. You don't want to spend $120,000 on the truck.
$60,000
on the Tahoe. $80,000 on the Lincoln Navigator or something like that. Go look at the Telluride. They will be out soon. But you can't have that one. Because I got it, though. All right, YouTube. Deuces.